بنيت بطوبي تجاري.
But what a great ni'mat of Allah that so many years away, over 1000 years away from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Islam today is still in its original and pristine purity, untouched by any man, unchanged by anyone, and unadulterated. And that is a great favor from Allah. 1441 years have passed. Not an extra dot has entered the Quran. Not an extra vowel has entered or taken out from the Quran. And not a single new teaching has been interpolated in Islam, whether it is the commentary of the Quran or the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It has remained in its pristine purity, and that is on account of the hifadat and protection which Allah has himself given for the deen of Islam. And my dear respected brothers and my dear elders, this will continue even if Islam continues for thousands and thousands and millions of years. Insha'Allah, no change shall come to it. That is the promise of Allah. But this protection of the deen that has come about, and the preservation of the true deen of Allah, it comes with sacrifice. It comes with trials and tribulations. And in order for it to be in the same manner it is, or it was at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, thousands of lives had to be sacrificed. People had to be condemned for upholding the truth. People's necks were beheaded for upholding the truth. People were imprisoned for upholding the truth. Their bones were broken. They were tied with chains on their feet and on their necks. They were beaten night and day because they will not tolerate anybody bringing any change to the deen of Allah. And we can well remember the trials of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, and the imprisonment of Imam Abu Hanifa, and the imprisonment and the exiling of Imam Shafi alayhi rahma, and the hands of Imam Malik being cut off by the king so he may not write anything else. The purity of Islam that remains today didn't come except with blood and sweat being given. And so it shall continue until the day of judgment, that whenever the call is made to protect not only Islam, but to protect the true teachings of Islam, a sacrifice must always be made. The sacrifice will come about by hearing the taunts of other people, by being called kuffar and mushrik, by being called heretics and deviants, by being called non-Muslims, by slams being thrown, by humiliation, by names. But what our Prophet had to go through to bring about Islam, what we are going through and what the scholars have gone through, is nothing in comparison to his mujahid and sacrifice. And that is the long-lasting lesson that our Messenger has given to us. قُلْ الْحَقْ وَلَوْ كَانَ مُرًّا. Speak the truth even though it is bitter. Even though it is bitter, uphold the truth. أفضل الجهاد أن تقول كلمة الحق عند سلطان جائر أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. The greatest jihad that a man can ever do is to speak the truth in front of an unjust and oppressive ruler, because the one who is speaking the truth knows very well the thing that will happen after he speaks the truth is the sword on his neck. He knows very well that will happen. And so my dear respected brothers and my dear elders, the point I'm making is that the topic of discussion which has been highlighted, the creed of the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'at, this in itself, the fact that we have today that pure deen of Allah, that is a great favor of Allah. But with you and I living over a thousand years away from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we could not get it except with the sacrifice of innocent people and great leaders of the past.
it's about time that we got together under this banner, and it's about time that we began to respond to some of the allegations that have been taking place.
I guess that's the end of them.
No, it is just the beginning.
These are dark times, there is no denying.